I initially wasn't even going to watch this game. I was actually planning to boycott because fuck Brazil and their authoritarian WEF dictatorship. Due to one of Brazil's many BS rules, we couldn't wear green, so the Eagles decided to wear a uniform combo that they'd never worn before. The black helmets are back, which I'm pretty happy about, although they honestly could be better. They don't absorb as much light as, say, Jacksonville's per se. They went with black helmet, white jersey, and black pants. Speaking of Jacksonville, it kind of reminds me of their standard away colors. And now I thought the Packers were initially going to wear their throwbacks, the yellow and blue, the Acme Packers, but nah, they're going with their standard. We were a bit confused because we thought teams couldn't wear green. Packers, man, they just did it. The ball's on these guys. Now I'm intrigued. Now I'm curious to see exactly how this game is going to go about, so I said, screw it, I might as well just check it out. So it starts off a little, rocky. It was a nice back and forth game. I had a feeling that the refs were going to screw Green Bay in some capacity because of their choice of wearing green or something. Eagles started off, Jalen picking up where he left off last year, turning the ball over, but Green Bay couldn't really capitalize off it because they kept getting bullshit penalties called on Green Bay, kept them out of the end zone. And that allowed Philly to take the lead, and we ended up being down at the half, 17-19. It was a nice, closely fought contest. Both defenses played pretty well in the first half. The second half is when both offenses started to really take off. Saquon Barkley, hell of a debut, man. Yeah, he didn't get that many. He wasn't exactly tearing up the defense for the most part, but when he got his opportunities, he made the most of it. I believe he got 3 touchdowns on the day. A.J. Brown got a touchdown. Jalen got 2 touchdown passes along with 2 INTs. Coughed up the ball. That was a good defensive play, but he was still trying to force something that wasn't there. Devontae Smith wasn't even open. The second one was a bit of miscommunication between him and Cam Jurgens, a.k.a. Beef Jergy. I get that this is their first full game they played together, but they've been practicing this all offseason. Okay, just dust yourself off. The third one, he was trying to force something that wasn't there, and it was just really boneheaded. But I gotta give credit where it's due. Green Bay's defense does exactly what it's supposed to do. That's how you play against top QBs. That's what you do against guys like that. You force them into situations where they make mistakes. Force them to make mistakes. Force them into disadvantage. Our defense, on the other hand, they were definitely frustrated. They were still back in their corners 15 yards off, still making it a bit easy for Jordan Love at times. But I can't get too mad at Fangio because he actually looked good his defense looked pretty good in the first half. And they've made some key stops in the second half. But I have to give credit to Jordan Love, man. He's out there to prove that last year was no fluke. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough in the end. Green Bay went in there with no fear, and it was very difficult to get inside the head of a team like that with that kind of mentality. But it wasn't enough for them to overcome Philly, although they definitely got some referee help. Of course, we weren't exactly doing ourselves any favors with key mistakes. We made some boneheaded play calls deep in crunch time, but Jalen was not perfect. He's still a turnover machine, but I'll give credit to Green Bay's defense for forcing uncomfortable situations, and he still helped us. He still did exactly what he needed to do, and we got the victory. And I'm proud of that. If I'm Green Bay, honestly, I'm fuming. Because I honestly believe that Green Bay was robbed on multiple occasions throughout the course of the game. They arguably should have beaten the shit out of us in the first half. And it seemed like there were multiple times. Of course, they didn't get that many more penalties than we did. But the penalties that were called on Green Bay were in situations that gave Philly ridiculous advantages. And it's such a shame. But overall, this was a nice classic. This was a beautiful game. It wasn't perfect, but it was a nice clinic. It was a classic. It was a back and forth between two teams trying to get one over on the other. Green Bay, it's a shame what happened to Jordan Love at the end of that game. Oof. Talk about brutal. And I think C.J. Gardner-Johnson left. I think A.J. Brown left. But I think he came back in. I'm not positive. But again, it's really frustrating for Green Bay, and I kind of feel for them. This game could have easily gone the other way. Either way, I'm happy. And I'm even more happy that we got the dub. Let's see how this translates going into the future. Yeah, we made some mistakes. Yeah, we looked rather questionable. But it looks like we're back on track. And at least we made mistakes. At least we looked like this against teams that are actually good. We actually are looking rather suspect against top teams. Teams that are meant to give us hard times. Green Bay is tough, man. They're no pushovers. They're out to prove something. And so are the Eagles. Green Bay is out to prove that last year was no fluke. And the Eagles are out to prove that last year was a fluke. Let's just see what's going on. I'm going to enjoy this one final ride for myself. I'm pretty happy. Of course, I'm sorry if this wasn't the usual rah-rah kind of thing. I mean, I had to go away from my usual filming location. My ride nearly got stolen, but thank God it was just nearly tossed in the woods because they didn't have the keys. Ugh. Talk about a scare. And the cops were all over that spot, but they were able to help me find it, so I had to switch to a new location, so unfortunately this is what I'm going to have to do. Anyway, let's just stay tuned for next time. Looking forward to seeing what they do next week, man. I'm just enjoying the ride. I'm just going with the flow, as usual. And I'm pretty happy about tonight. Anyway, you take care of yourselves. Enjoy yourselves.